Hey guys, today is a collector's delight, if I may call it that, because today I wanted to show you a section of my Gotham comics collection, which is a huge one, because that's one thing which I'm passionately going after and trying to get the entire series off, which is not extremely difficult like getting the entire collection of Indrajal comics. Nor is it so easy to get any of the modern publications from Graphic India or anything which is very easily available. So I think this will be in the middle. It's becoming harder and harder because as the years pass by, obviously the books also start fading out. Gotham comics for me is also a very nostalgia evoking set of comics because I grew up and have spent a lot of my schoolhood time reading this bunch of stuff, right? And I was very fascinated when they came out. They came out in 2001 when I was, I think, right around my 10th standard exams, board exams and all stuff were going on. So that's when they came out, and it was a perfect time for me to jump in because the exams just got over or something. It was my summer holidays. No pressure, and there they were sitting on the comic shelves. I just started picking them up by the bunches, right? So today, what the first thing which I'm going to show you here is, and Gotham Comics, by the way, rebooted I think at least a couple of times or so. They tried to get more of their inventory out, and by the way, it was not a runaway success. In fact, finally they had to shut shop and move to other Asian locales like Singapore, Malaysia, etc. to publish the comics because it is not doing so well in India. And later finally they moved to Virgin comic line, and finally they rebooted as Graphic India with India's own version of characters like Devi, Sadhu, even Mahabharata, Ramayana and the likes. That's for another time. But yeah, so this one which I have here, I have a set of I think 4 comics. These are the magazine size edition. The interesting thing you will note is it's spelled as magazine, right? It's not M-A-G-I, it is M-E-G-A, right? So this is one of the first issue that came out. I have hunted for this a lot, and I got a very pristine condition book in my hand, if you look at it from that angle, right? So this has fused, and the paper quality is not that good. It's the newspaper print quality, and there's somewhat 4 chapters, Red Tide, the RIP, Gears of Justice and Death Engine inside this. Obviously for Gotham Comics, I think many of you would know that it's brought to us by Sharad Devarajan and Suresh Sitaraman, right? And of course licensed by Gotham Entertainment Group from US. So it's a pretty thick book, and the good part is they number it, so I think it's 100 pages. Yeah, it's 100 page and it's called out right outside. By the way, I don't blame them for the quality of paper. I think it's a decent quality, which helps you read the stories, and it's not glossy, but it's obviously 100 page and it's just $95. So I mean, I don't think you can complain about it a lot. So I'm just showing you a few pages from it, that's all, right? So 4 stories in this one, and the second one from this is again the Batman magazine, right? It's not Superman, it's Batman again, featuring Superman. So he's on the cover page. Again, I think this has some 3 or 4 stories. The first one is a Batman one. I think there is, yeah, obviously there is a story of Superman coming in. This is another story of, I actually quite forgot what these stories were about, right? Because it's been some time since I read this. It's a good time actually to read them again. But yeah, it's mostly dominated this book by Superman stories versus Batman stories. Just one Batman, and mostly it is Superman. So the title is kind of like a misnomer, right? There you can see a good page of Hulk. And then I have a couple of Spider-Man ones here, right? This is the first one. This is this is a part of the Ultimate Spider-Man series. Yeah, it's the Marvel Ultimate Spider-Man series there. Again, a super-sized magazine. So this is the first part, his origin. There used to run a lot of contests, by the way, guys, right? And they used to give away good action figures for the winners who drew it. It was a very good marketing tactics and getting people hooked on, but unfortunately it didn't stick as much as they wanted. Here they are actually even showing the Batman magazine inside this one. And then the final one is the second part of the Marvel Ultimate Spider-Man, when the Green Goblin enters, right? For anybody who is familiar with the movie, they already know this story. The good part about all these books are it's in a A4 plus format, magazine format. So it feels good to read the stories in your hand, which is a good part, right? So this is the second part, and it ends with Spider-Man getting introduced. I think this it does finish off, I believe. Yeah, so I don't have any more of these, guys, right? I have only these four which I've showed you just now. I don't know also if there are more to this. There are more books in this line. I have not come across so far. But if you guys know about it and you think that my collection is still incomplete, I need to pick up few more from the magazine line, feel free to let me know, and I will definitely try to get my hands on them. So that's it. Hope you liked this video of Gotham Comics. I have much more of this stuff to share. So do subscribe and keep watching out for more. Thank you.